In 2006, I interviewed an activist from the Polish community,
Mr. Swobodziuk,
who for 50 years was a member of the Union of Poles in Denmark. I did this interview at the request of the editor-in-chief of the Polish quarterly magazine, Informata. Of course, I prepared myself very carefully for the interview, but this man did not want to talk about his activities in the Union, but talked all the time about the Polish resistance organization, Felicja, about its first commander, second commander, about Lone, about love, about death, about betrayal.
O miłości, o śmierci, o zdradzie I było to tak pasjonujące, że
And he was so passionate that after leaving, I thought to myself, I have to get to the bottom of this story.
I oczywiście nie myślałam wtedy
Of course, I was not thinking about writing the book then. I was more interested in following the lead and tracing the lead to the Polish language teacher,
Adam Sokulski,
who was the first leader of Felicja. But as it turned out, fate wanted otherwise.
The book about Lone Monson was written in 6 years, the last year mostly preparing the book for printing.
Lone was born in Poland and spent her childhood and early youth there, but later returned to Denmark.
A później wróciła do Danii. I mogę powiedzieć,
and I can say that in Poland she learned the love of freedom. It must be remembered, though, that at this period, practically after Poland regained freedom, this is a period of the so-called patriotic education in Polish schools. Denmark, on the other hand, is where she learned traditions, the value of friendship, as well as other moral virtues. These were developed hand in hand with physical improvement.
Które to kształtowanie szło w parze z doskonaleniem się fizycznym, a więc
So the idea was that a healthy spirit should live in a healthy body. What are you doing, Mom? This is a surprise for your school in Jaroszowiec. Our family wants to offer it a banner. It will be dedicated on May 3rd. It is a great Polish holiday, my daughter. I hope that this value of patriotism will stay with you all your life.
Będzie przy tobie przez całe życie.
It was a life in a very loving family, self-respect, and one was respected, a family that led a very open and active social life. The father was the technical director of the local cement factory, so the family had a fairly good financial standard. The mother was interested in gardening and in weaving of tapestries. Around this family, there were friendly neighbors and friends. Lone had a lot of friends, and she had her beloved dog, Pucci.
Miała ukochanego swojego pieska, Pucci.
We can just imagine her, cheerful, nice, sympathetic, a well-liked girl, surrounded by beautiful nature.
I ukształtowania geograficznego, terenowego Jaroszowca. Właściwie cóż
Actually,
więcej dla
what, is more, what is more needed for a child? Climbing trees, mrówek, looking for ant eggs, discovering the nature of the world, więzi, multicultural ties, and of course love for this cozy, intimate house where the Lone family lived. She connected Poland with her home in Jaroszowiec, where she was born and lived with her family, and in time it became a symbol of all Poland, her first homeland. Here she had her first experience with friendships. Danusia was her great dear friend. Both these girls vowed a lifelong friendship and exchanged rings.
pierścionkami.
Danusia, do you promise me a lifelong friendship? I promise. Until death do us part, until death do us part. Unfortunately, it was quite a tragic friendship because Danusia had a serious heart defect. And a few years after Lone's departure from Jaroszlawiec, she unfortunately passed away. As agreed upon, the ring Danusia got from Lona was put into her coffin. At the end of 1933, the decision was made to close the cement plant because the production of Portland cement was too expensive.
Ponieważ produkcja cementu portlandzkiego była zbyt droga.
Over a period, the devices were dismantled. The entire technological line was shut down, and Lona's father supervised the process. My head aches thinking of the situation of the cement plant. Is it true what the local people say? What, for instance? They say the cement plant will shut down. If this happens, your father and I will start considering moving away from Jaroszlawiec. To where? Back to Denmark, to the land of our ancestors. Perhaps this will be our new home. Lona, however, did not stay in Denmark. About the same time, her older brother, Jorgen Monsen, later was employed in the Danish embassy in Warsaw. He had returned from France.
Który został pracownikiem duńskiego poselstwa w Warszawie i Lonę.
Lona visited her brother very often. She stayed many times over the months with her brother and sister-in-law when Jorgen came from Grenoble. His Polish wife, Basia Hamicka, descended from the famous Hamicki family of the Nawenj coat of arms. Indeed, Denmark may have seemed foreign to Lona after such a long stay in Poland. But it must be remembered that during this time, Lona's family maintained their ties with Denmark, her country of origin. Lona's biggest problem turned out to be the Danish language. She knew very little, speaking Polish all the time. She even reproached her father that he never tried to learn it. She also spoke Polish with her brother and sister-in-law, because Jorgen, a graduate of the old secondary school, even knew the Polish national epic, Pan Tadeusz, by heart.
Absolwent gimnazjum olkuskiego znał Pana Tadeusza całego na pamięć.
We also know that the Union of Poles in Denmark sent congratulations on Lona's confirmation. We may say that when returning back to Denmark, the family brought their little house with them. In Denmark, Lona became involved in the activities of those Danish organizations that began to oppose the policy of the Danish government. At this point, perhaps it's worth mentioning her participation in the Danish scouting program. She was also a member of the Danish Nordic Youth Union, which continued the patriotic traditions of the Union of Young Border Defenders. Lona was a member of the Conservative Youth Party. The party also protested against the policy of the Danish government by taking part in numerous demonstrations.
Również poprzez udział w wielu manifestacjach.
Like many young Danes in this organization, she dealt with distributing newspapers and participating in demonstrations. Until these organizations adopted much more forceful forms of fighting against Germany.
Ruch oporu, który podjął już znacznie bardziej zdecydowane formy walki z Niemcami.
At the same time, Lona joined the nascent Polish resistance organization, Felicja. In 1942, Lona swears allegiance to Felicja. Through Felicja, she establishes contacts with Polish military intelligence at the base of Stockholm. Felicja is not an organization whose members fight in arms. The task of Felicja is to collect all kinds of information and intelligence about ship traffic in the Danish Straits, about plane flights, airports, and other facilities serving Germany.
Na temat lotnisk i innego rodzaju obiektów, które służą Niemcom. Wszystkie te
All this information is collected and forwarded to the Polish government in London.
Zbierane i przekazywane do rządu w Londynie. Przychodzi również czas,
There comes a time when the organization is equipped with a radio and messages are sent to London.
Poprzez właśnie to urządzenie wysyłane są komunikaty do Londynu.
Lona, while still in the people's school, became interested in photography. And after returning from this stage of training, she took a course with the then photographer of the royal family.
Zrobiła kurs u ówczesnego fotografa rodziny królewskiej i została
fotografem. It was very useful in her work in Felicja, because she photographed all kinds of military objects in a very professional way, and then took microfilms of these photos. Lona's father was a cement specialist, and therefore knew all about cement. He once revealed the secret that sugar added to cement during its production disintegrates the final form of cement.
W trakcie robienia tego, produkowania tego cementu, powoduje, iż w końcowej formie cement zaczyna się kruszyć.
As soon as Lona heard about that, she started organizing a sugar collection with her Danish scouting friends. At the same time, sugar was rationed in Denmark, and it was not an easy task. But she and her friends would go from house to house and ask for sugar. Later, this sugar was shipped and added to the cement, which was then used by the Germans in all kinds of fortifications and structures. At the same time, the Germans were strengthening the Atlantic Wall and building a number of military fortifications in Jutland. In any case, it is known that Lucjan Masłocha was a frequent guest of Basia Homicka Monsen. There he met her daughter, Krupka. Krupka remembers these contacts very well because Masłocha, a very lively, happy, energetic man with social connections, repeatedly addressed this little girl, saying to her, Princess, how do you feel today? How beautiful you look. Although it is known, he was thinking about a slightly different princess. Say hello to the gentleman. Fine, Mom. Good morning, sir. How is the princess today? Will the princess accept homage from her faithful subject? What mood are you in today, princess? I'm good. Who is this woman? This is my sister-in-law, Lona. I'm delighted to meet you, Miss Lona. It was a secret wedding ceremony at the Catholic St. Ansgar Cathedral in Copenhagen.
Katedrze Świętego Ansgara w Kopenhadze.
2 years ago, a plaque was placed there to commemorate this ceremony. The plaque was unveiled by President Andrzej Duda, together with the Catholic Bishop of Denmark, Czesław Kozan. This is how the wedding took place. There were no bells, no wedding processions, no groomsmen, no family. The church was almost empty and dimly lit. The wedding ceremony was hosted by a Danish parish priest who knew they were both underground. It was New Year's Eve, a frosty but very sunny day on December 31st, 1944. The wedding took place after sunset. After the wedding, the newlyweds went to the restaurant for a glass of wine. But earlier, Lona was given a bouquet of tea roses because there were no other roses then. This color of roses scared her. It didn't fit very well with the wedding. However, she went with this bouquet to the wedding ceremony. However, it was not possible to visit you. Here things turned out differently than we expected. I got married on your birthday at 4 p.m. He is 31 years old and an officer. I don't need to tell you how happy and lucky I am. We got married and went to Groningen. It's a restaurant to get a bottle of wine. I had a bouquet of tea roses. It was our only decoration. The circumstances of Lona and her husband's death remain a mystery. 3 days after the wedding, at night, a unit of Germans and Danes, members of the Hippo Auxiliary Police, entered the house where Lucjan lived. In this house, Lucjan had his secret hideout, which also contained a radio station. The owner of the villa opened the door. Some claimed that the Gestapo-led unit knew the secret signal. Lucjan shouldn't be there. He was leaving to see his superiors in London, but unfortunately, German control appeared on his ship. When he got out of the manhunt, he had to postpone his departure and returned to Lona. Unfortunately, he left his gun on the ship. Was someone following him? Or maybe Lona was to be killed? To this day, we do not know the answers to these questions. Lona was killed on the spot, pierced by a series of bullets from a submachine gun. Lucjan survived another week. The Germans took him to a military hospital, where they tried to get secrets from him by injection. Both bodies were laid at the site of today's Mindelin Memorial Cemetery. It was on August 30th, 1945, the state funeral of the fighters found in the place, where Germans had used as a shooting range and a place of execution of the resistance members. Niemcy zamienili na miejsce egzekucji członków ruchu oporu.